Hello and welcome back. Today we will learn how to automate the rank function using VBA. But before we do that, let us see how the rank function is used manually. So here I have data of names of students and their marks, and we want to assign them a rank out of these values. You can also have ranking of items and their sales. Okay, so let's start with the student marks, because many teachers have requested for the ranking function. Therefore, let us study it on this example. So I will write here is equal to rank, and then I can select this rank here. And you will also notice that there is something called rank.eq and rank.avg. Now the rank function, this function is available for compatibility with Excel 2007 and earlier. Returns the rank of a number in a list of numbers. Its size relative to other values in the list. So that is what rank does. Now let us look at rank.eq. So returns the rank of a number in a list of number, its size relative to the other values in the list. If more than one value has the same rank, the top rank of that set of values is returned. Actually, when I did this, there was not much of a difference. Then the rank average. Returns the rank of a number in a list of numbers, its size relative to other values in the list. If more than one value has the same rank, the average rank is returned. So I will start with the rank first. Press the tab key. For the rank function, you need these three parameters, out of which the order is optional. So number is the, let us say, marks whose rank you want to find among these marks. So comma, and what is the reference? The reference are these total number of marks of different students. Right, comma, and then you can have two options: descending rank number, as if reference were a list sorted in descending order. If you take ascending rank number, as if reference were a list sorted in ascending order. So let me take ascending. So I'll press the tab key and the parenthesis close. Now, before we can press enter, it's a good idea to make this a fixed reference by pressing F4 from your keyboard. So here I'll press F4. And you see, now this reference range has been fixed, so you will not get errors. So we'll press enter, and the rank is 10. That means out of these 10 numbers, this has the highest rank. I can now fill it down, and you will get the different ranks. So if you notice here carefully, you have 80, same marks for two people, for Harry and Irfan. Now he has a rank 3, Irfan, and Harry also has a rank 3. So we cannot differentiate using rank. Alright. Also, if you had not done this fixing of this reference range, you would have got errors. We will also understand how to change this to 3 and 4 in a bit. In fact, I will automate the process for you. So let us go and see the rank.eq function in action. So we will write equal to rank, and this time I will select rank.eq, and again I have to take a number, comma, the reference range, which are all the marks here, the range of marks, comma, again I will take ascending. We want to keep this similar. So parenthesis is closed, and we will fix this range to avoid any errors. F4, I press F4 from the keyboard and press enter. Now, if I fill this, you see there is no difference. Let's do the final one, rank average. So we'll assign the value rank average number, comma, the reference range, number of all the marks of the students. Reference will again take ascending, and parenthesis closed. And I press enter. Now you see, when I do the filling here, you see what it does. So in the process, you also got to know that you get number of errors if you don't fix this range. That means it should be fixed, should have a fixed value. So we'll press F4 here, F4, and enter. Now we can do the autofill to get correct values. Otherwise, you will get such silly values. Okay? So this range must be fixed. And now you see the world looks different and correct. And you can see here, both these values, which were the same, have been assigned average values. Average of what? Average of 7. Because one would be 3 and the other would be 4. The first one that occurs at the top will normally be ranked as 4, and the one that comes below will be ranked as 3. After doing this, it should be quite easy now to automate the process, but you will see that automation has its own intricacies. So, let's go to the Developer tab, Visual Basic. I'll just close this one. We'll go to Insert, Module. So, in this module, I'll have this macro called sub assign ranks. Press Enter. We will declare a few variables now. So dim, I as long, last row as long, now we get our last row by using this equation. We will say application dot worksheet function dot count A, and we'll count the range A which has the names. So range in quotes A to A, quotes closed, parenthesis closed, and parenthesis closed. If you wanted to know the value, you could just write message box last row. Okay, we can do that. So message box last row. If we run this now by clicking on the run button, you see we get our last row, which is the 11th row. Okay? So we can put an apostrophe here to remark this out so that the line of code will not be processed. And now we can go for the rank function. So we will say for I, assign the value 2, because that's where our names and marks start, to last row right next I, and we will write our rank function. So cells I, 3 will get the value from application dot worksheet function dot rank and we'll use the cells property. So cells I comma 2 comma here we need to fix the range as you saw. So we will use range in quotes B2, that is our column 2, colon B, quotes close, and here we will use the last row. So that will fix our range, comma, we want ascending, so we will say 1, quotes closed, and our code for this ranking is done. So we'll just go to the Excel worksheet and I'll delete this here. Okay, we'll go back to Visual Basic and we can run this macro assigned ranks. So I'll click on the run button and there you see the ranks have been assigned. Now a teacher wanted to know how to assign, for example, this value not as 1, but she wanted fail here because the marks are below 35. 35 is the minimum marks that you need to pass the exam. So we will do that also now. So what we will do now, in this looping process itself, we will say if cells I comma 2 is less than 35, then we will write the value cells I comma 3 will be assigned the value fail. Else we will have this value, so and if. So if the value in column 2, which is B range, is less than 35, then the subroutine must assign the value fail, else it should assign the rank. Okay, so we will run this now and there you see the value for 30 has been assigned as fail. The next thing we will do is to assign values with the same rank to proper values like 3 and 4. And you will notice because these two values are the same, the rank 4 is not assigned to any other marks. That means the ranking jumps to 5. The next macro that I write now will assign the proper values to Harry and Irfan mathematically. Okay, so we'll go back to the developer tab, Visual Basic, going to insert another module and I'm going to paste my macro that I've already created right here and I will explain it to you line by line. Because it is long, it will take a lot of time to write. So, to make the video shorter, I'm going to do this. I have named this subroutine assigning rank to same ranks. Okay, for Harry and Irfan. So, we declare again a few variables. Then we have another variable called extra value. I'm not assigning it any data type because this is a decimal and I want Excel to do it on its own. So you can think of it as a variant data type. The last row assignment happens like in the last macro. Now we do a looping process. However, this is a nested looping. What we do is we start looping from the row 2 to the last row, and then we compare that value that we get in the first row to the consecutive rows in the same column. And if we find that two values are equal, then we calculate an extra value, and that is done as follows. We count our range. And this is very important. So we count our range like this, the number of values. Let's say we have 10 of them. We add 1. Then we subtract from that a rank that we find using the descending values. Okay, so 0. This will give us the rank in descending order. Important thing to note is that our range is again written like this so that it is fixed. Then we subtract from the total count also the value of the rank that we get by using 1, that is when we have the ascending ranking. The total value we divide by 2. And generally the value you will get is 0.5. So if some ranking is 3, it will become 3.5. And that we add to our original value that we got. Let's say we got 3 and we get 3.5, and then we round it up. So in that process, for the topmost value here, for Harry, we'll get a ranking of 4 because this comes first, and Irfan's ranking of 3 will remain. Alright? So, when we run the inner loop and when we go back to the outer loop here, we again initialize our J value back to I so that when I goes to the next row, the J value becomes I plus 1. So if I am going to row 3 here, J will become 4. So that the checking is done meticulously. Okay. So let's run this now by clicking on the run button. Let's go back to our Excel worksheet. And there you see Harry has been assigned the value 4. And Irfan gets the value 3. Now, this is what we call an Excel calculation. But the teacher may find that Irfan has performed very well during the year, so she may assign this the value ranking 4 and Harry the ranking 3, and she can use certain criteria which she can write down here and which we can check programmatically also. Okay, so you see the automation process goes very well. If you had done it manually, that will of course take time. Now, if you wanted to calculate the grades, you could do that also. So I'm going to write the code for that. so that you can use it in your work. So we'll go to the Developer tab, Visual Basic. We'll insert another module and I will paste the code here. It's very simple code. I have shown this also as a sample project in my YouTube videos, but I will explain this to you quickly. We call this sub the assign grades. We declare two long variables. We assign the last row to this value like we did last time. And then we have a loop. So for I is equal to 2 to last row, if the cell value I, 2, that means row 2, column 2 in the first instance is greater than or equal to 90A, that is our I, 4. So I, 4 would mean 1, 2, 3, 4. It would come here. We don't want that. We want to come in the 6th column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This code was written for the column 4. So we'll change this to 6 because we want it in the right place. Our marks are in column 2, so that remains as it is. And you see, if the person gets marks greater than or equal to 35, he will pass, but if less than that, he will fail, or she will fail. So this is how grades are assigned. This is pretty easy. So let's run this now. And there you see the grades have been assigned, and here it was fail, here it is also fail. Tom just got 40, so he has passed, but some of the people have got different grades. But in the ranking is little better, so you can assign grades in a more nuanced manner. Now, once you have finished this, you may like to clear the grades, or you may like to clear the rank, so you can do that. You can just write code to clear that range. Finally, we will save the file. So we will go to File, Save As. I'm going to save it on the desktop. I will write the name here, Automating Rank Worksheet Function. I will save it as a Excel macro enabled workbook. Save, and that's done. I would like to tell you a few more things. So let's go back from the Developer tab to Visual Basic. You notice here that I'm declaring these variables, and these are the same variables that I'm using. So in module 1, I have the same variables. In module 2 also, I'm using the same variables. So you can think of using these variables as global variables. That means you declare them right at the top in a module so that they can be available to all the modules, and you need not repeat the variables. I found creating the code for this rank function in such a manner very interesting. I hope you enjoyed it too. If you enjoyed it, please like and share. Thanks for watching.